hours. If you're watching this and you're over 50, know that this, what you're going to learn here, this is the approach you want to follow for exercise. You will see late night infomercials on television in America that you know, talk about these vigorous 1 hour long daily exercise routines. Those are not often appropriate for men and women over a certain age because that can be dangerous to your knees. They can be dangerous to your bones.
Dangerous, painful, even a waste of your time.
And a waste of time.
Your valuable time. You want to do other things as you age too. You want to be able to enjoy hobbies and art and music and theater. And you don't want to be relegated to spending hours in a gym.
Right.
That's not necessary.
But the right exercise, 30 to 60 minutes a week. Some of these ideas you're going to learn.
A week, not a day.
Yeah, 30 to 60 minutes a week. You're going to learn some of these techniques in this conversation, and you can go deeper on our new longevity quest with Ben Greenfield. But this is what can transform the health and wellness of men and women over 50. And that brings us to the third big lie, which is essentially that we need to spend hours and hours and hours exercising to be at our best. Ben?
You look at the blue zones, right? These longevity hot spots all around the world where people are living a disproportionately long period of time. We see low-level physical activity throughout the day. We see good air. We see quality exposure to sunshine. We see clean water. What we don't see are people spending hours and hours per week or per day beating themselves up in a gym, as seems to be the philosophy and the approach, especially in many westernized countries where we have gyms, so we just go to them because they're there and we spend way too much time in them. The fact is, you don't need to spend that amount of time exercising. And the reason for that is that if you structure your life the way that I teach in this quest to structure your life, enhancing not only your fitness, but your movement, your recovery, your overall health, exercise becomes almost like the icing on the cake. Meaning, when you incorporate all these other elements into your life, it's that last little thing that you do for that last little bit of fitness that you want to look good in your t-shirt or that pair of jeans that you love or your swimsuit or whatever the reason is that you want to add in that fitness component. But as long as you structure things accordingly and you use the strategies in this program, exercise is not something that involves beating yourself up in a gym for 30 or 60 or 90 minutes a day as we see so many people doing.
And science is now proving this. You've maybe heard about the science of minimum effective dose exercise, or the scientists who have studied approaches like Tabata, where 4 minutes of exercise can give you the same impact as 30 minutes of aerobic activity.
4 minutes of exercise. It's actually the Tabata. I'm glad you brought that up because it's a perfect example of the style of exercise you'd find in this program, where instead of spending 30 minutes on a treadmill, you spend 4 minutes of 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off, boom, you're done. Another perfect example is research they've done on controlling your blood glucose. It takes only 30 seconds of exercise before you eat.
That's
actually
mind-blowing research.
Your ability to be able to not have a big blood glucose response when you eat carbohydrates. 30 seconds. And so, yeah, I mean, it comes down to this fact that you have X amount of time in your day, 24 hours for most people, for just about everybody. You want to be able to spend that time doing the things that you enjoy and doing the things that you love. And I understand that exercise and fitness is fun and it's something that a lot of people love, but it should not be something that you're required to do for hours and hours a week, especially if that's not something that you even enjoy or find interesting.
So what we're really developing here, guys, is a lifestyle change methodology. This changes your lifestyle. This is not an exercise program. You will learn the right exercises to do. You will learn the right movement. You will learn new cutting-edge techniques, which you may never have heard about before, like homesis, but this is not an exercise program. So you're in for a treat. Ben, tell us about big lie number four.
So big lie number four is that you can look good and you can look young without necessarily being fit. Now, as we've just alluded to, this doesn't mean that you have to spend hours and hours in a gym to attain the levels of fitness that require you to have longevity and health and beauty. But you do, in fact, need to be fit. And again, returning to these blue zones, we see manual physical labor throughout the day. We see occasionally lifting heavy things. We see occasional sprinting. We see what our ancestors would have experienced, whether that might be running from a lion or a saber-toothed tiger or chasing down a woolly mammoth for dinner, building a fence, lifting a rock, constructing a home. Now, I understand that not everybody lives the life of a construction worker or a hunter or a gatherer or a gardener. If you do, then you're lucky in that your life is keeping you fit. But the fact is, to stay young and live a long time, especially in our post-industrial era, where we're relegated many times to be sitting at work, sitting on the subway, sitting on a bus, sitting on an airplane, you do need to include some element of fitness, of lifting heavy things, of moving fast, of moving slow, of engaging in mobility and recovery in order to experience true and optimized health, longevity, and beauty. So these four strategies need to go hand in hand. Fitness, health, beauty, and longevity. You nail those four strategies, which you're going to learn in this quest, and you've got your bases covered. But the fact is,